I don't know about you, but I like writing less code, particularly boilerplate code. Alongside API 24, we've included support for a number of Java 8 language features with the help of the Jack toolchain. To use any of these new features, you'll need to enable the Jack toolchain. All it takes is just a few lines of code in your build.gradle file, and you're all set. Now to cut that boilerplate code. Firstly, you'll be able to use Lambda expressions, a simplified way of expressing functional interfaces, interfaces with just a single method. This allows us to rewrite our onClick listeners from all this down to something a little easier to look at. You'll note that parameter types are optional. Here we're using braces to allow you to have multiple statements, just like a normal method, but if you only have a single expression, you can leave them out. A sister feature to Lambda expressions, method references allow you to use existing methods as Lambda expressions, making those one-line Lambda expressions even shorter. The best part about these features, they're backward compatible, down to Gingerbread. So whether you're building for the latest version of Android or not, you'll be able to shave off some boilerplate code. This works because the Jack toolchain is able to implement these new features using anonymous classes, just as if you had written the old version of the code yourself. That also means you shouldn't go overboard with using them in tight loops or anything. They're still relatively expensive. However, if you are MinSDK version 24, you've entered a magical land where you can take advantage of a number of additional features. For example, Lambda expressions go perfectly with the stream APIs, which allow you to chain together multiple operations, such as filtering, mapping, or converting into different types before applying a terminating method, such as sum for a stream events, or for each for applying a Lambda expression to every remaining item. Oh, and it supports running in parallel out of the box. Crazy powerful stuff, and I'd encourage you to check out the docs for all the details, as there's a lot of them. Interfaces also got an upgrade with the ability to add default method implementations and static methods. This makes it easy to add new methods to an interface without having to update every implementation of the interface, and allows you to place static helper methods related to an interface in the interface itself. And if you're a fan of annotations, and I know some of you are, you'll be able to take advantage of repeating annotations to add the same annotation more than once, particularly useful if you have an annotation that accepts different type elements. So, lots of great new features, both in the backward compatible and non-backward compatible nature. New tools to help you build better apps.